should be good now.
Okay, so we're going to have a chat. This is a year 13, a level 3 way of thinking about induced voltages. And so we've got these squiggles on the whiteboard here. Epsilon is minus d phi by dt. Epsilon, that's a familiar looking character. What did that mean last time? That was in physics class. Do you remember we used it for voltage back when we were talking about internal resistance? That epsilon was the symbol for the chemical potential inside the battery. And so epsilon is the symbol for the induced voltage measured in volts. And you'll know from calculus class that d anything by dt is the rate of change of that thing. And that phi there is the magnetic flux. And that is a minus sign, which is the universal physics symbol for opposing, right? And so the question I can hear on your lips is, what is this flux thing? And so flux is the idea of combining together a flow of something through an area. And so when we're thinking about like magnetic flux, what we're thinking about is we have an area, an imaginary area, the flux is equal to the amount of magnetic field that is perpendicular to that area. So magnetic flux, phi, is B cross A. Remembering that the cross means that the magnetic field and the area have to be at right angles to each other. And the least known unit of level 3 physics, the unit for magnetic flux, is Weber's WB. But you could also have Tesla meters squared B, an acceptable unit.
So is that Weber's per second for the rate of change of magnetic flux?
Yeah, so if we come back, nice. You see the circle that we had to fill in this question mark before we fill this. The rate of change of magnetic flux can be measured in Weber's per second or Tesla meters squared per second. And so what Faraday noticed when he wrote down the law for electromagnetic induction is that an induced voltage just depends on the rate of change of magnetic flux or magnetic field through an area. And so the ways that we can cause a voltage to be induced are by changing the magnetic field strength, by turning our magnet up or down in strength, which we could do by turning our magnet around, moving it one way or the other, to vary how much of the magnetic field goes through that area. We could change it by changing the area. If we reduce the size of the area, we're reducing the magnetic flux. We could reduce the size by turning that area around through 90 degrees, because then the area would be parallel to the magnetic field and we'd have no magnetic flux. And so as well as reducing the physical size, we can also change the orientation of these things to change their values. And the other thing that Faraday noticed is that the quicker these things, these changes happen, the greater the voltages that we get induced. So what we're going to do next time is we're going to link this back to our level 2 way of thinking about induced voltage. So our V is equal to, how do we do induced voltages? BVL. We're going to have a think about our induced voltages V with BVL at level 2 and persuade ourselves that it's exactly the same.
What are those squiggles?
Do you feature over
Do you feel like you're going back to primary school again? Teaching you to make squiggles on the whiteboard.